Today I'm upgrading to Wi-Fi 6 and testing the before and the after. Stay tuned. So let's jump straight into the speed test with my old router, which is a TP-Link WRT841N. I'm measuring speeds with my laptop, my Android phone and my wife's iPhone. I'll be measuring speeds from my living room, where the devices will be around 3 meters or 10 feet away from the router. From my office, where the devices will be around 10 meters or 32 feet away from the router. And my bedroom, where the devices will be 14 meters away or 46 feet away from the router. The first test is from the living room. Well, looking at the download speed chart, we can verify that the laptop actually held the download speed pretty well as further away we went from the router. The phones, while having similar download speeds in all rooms, saw their download speed being cut dramatically, going from the office to the bedroom. Looking at the upload speeds, a bit the same trend, with the laptop holding more or less okay in the living room and the office, but in the bedroom dropping for less than half the values recorded before. As for the phones, we see some consistency, with both phones achieving roughly the same upload speeds in both the office and the bedroom, the only exception being the living room, where the iPhone almost doubled the upload speed registered by the Android device. So, let's test the speeds with the new router, but before, let's check what's inside the box. Right, it's now time to check the speeds with the new router, starting once again with the living room. Let's take a look now at the compiled data, but just before that, please don't forget to like this video and to subscribe and activate the notifications by clicking on the bell button. Looking at the chart, we have in the upper part the speed test results with the new router, and on the bottom part the speed test results with the old router. It can be clearly seen that, overall, in all rooms, both download and upload speeds for all devices have increased. The only exception being the download and upload speeds for the laptop in the bedroom, which have reached just 34 and 18% of the speeds recorded before. Anyway, I'm happy with it, as I don't use the laptop in the bedroom at all. And honestly, I was having very strange results with the speed test app, and I had to switch to the browser, which was being flooded with ads, so I think that this might have had some influence. Overall, the laptop had an average speed increase of 106 and 67% for the download and upload speeds respectively, taking advantage of the 5 GHz frequency in the living room and the office. Regarding the phones, both took great advantage of the new router, also because of the use of the 5 GHz frequency, with the Android phone having a combined average speed increase of 322%. As for the iPhone, it had an average combined download speed increase of 493%, with an increase of 561% for the download speed in the living room and an increase of 800% in the office. Where we see the speeds decreasing, once again, is in the bedroom, where both the Android phone and the iPhone switch to the 2.4 GHz frequency. Anyway, for the Android device, there's an increase of 1231% in download speed, going from 1.63 megabits per second recorded with the old router to 21.7 megabits per second recorded with the new router. The Android phone also saw an increase of 129% in upload speed, going from 3.15 megabits per second to 7.2 megabits per second. As for the iPhone, it saw an increase in download speed of 119% and an upload speed increase of 183%, which is also great. Overall, I'm very happy with the purchase. If you still have an old single band router, but you have at home devices that support dual band, maybe it'd be a good idea to get one of these, as it truly made a difference in my home network. I have now better coverage with my phones anywhere in the flat, which led to better speeds. If you don't have any devices that could take advantage of one of these routers, getting one would future-proof your home network, as new devices will be compatible with newer wireless technologies. I'll leave you a link to these and other routers in the video description below, so you can compare them and see which one best fits your needs. Please don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe and activate the notifications by clicking on the bell button. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you soon.